We're on, so we want to welcome our live audience as well as the audience here. This is the Atlanta Internet Video Marketing Association hands-on training workshop. And our next presentation is on-camera delivery with Sachi Koto. I do want to thank our sponsors before we get started. We have Performance PC providing the live stream, and Tony Hale from there does all kinds of remote live webcasting. He can also provide systems for live webcasting. And Sony and Showcase are helping us with some of the expenses of this. And then, of course, Robbie and Michelle are providing this beautiful studio for us to have. And they're with Van Gogh Video. And the studio is available for renting. And then they also do webcasting from their studio. I've used them, and they do a great job. I want to thank all of them. And then CopyTalk.com is also a sponsor. And so we want to thank all of them. I am thrilled that Sachi Koto has decided to do this for us today. Sachi and I have been friends for a couple of years and worked on a couple of projects together. I always, when I was in my news career, picked out certain people that I love to just watch on television and everything. And Sachi was one of them. And I just think, you know, I loved her delivery, and she always just made you smile. You just couldn't watch her without smiling. And so when I got a chance to meet her here in Atlanta, I was just thrilled, and we've worked together. And so I'm very glad that she'll do this. I find I have a lot of clients who need a lot of help when it comes to reading a teleprompter. I always say that people know they can't fly an airplane, and they know they can't do brain surgery, but they can all be on television and read a teleprompter, you know? And then they get in the studio and they need some work. And it all starts with even the script that they're trying to do. So I'm so glad that Sachi will do that. And she, if you guys don't know, she was on CNN for years. And so many people all over the world know Sachi. So welcome, Sachi.
Thank you very much, Donna. And I appreciate the opportunity of being with you today. Some of the things that I'm going through are going to be very basic, and you're going to go, oh, who didn't know that? But there are other things that I hope that you will glean from this workshop, and that it will help you if you're ever in front of a teleprompter. The rundown today, we're going to talk about the basics of teleprompters. Some may know a lot about it. And then I want you to know that you are in control. So many people that I've helped with teleprompting, they never knew that. They thought that they were supposed to follow the teleprompter operator. So we'll talk about that. We'll talk about our expressions, the warmth, our how our eyes are supposed to smile while we're speaking, and how we engage the audience. We'll talk about breathing and relaxation, which will help you in facing the teleprompter. Also in scripting, that's so important to make it more conversational for you, and then pumping it up when you're reading the teleprompter. So many times I've felt like, man, I am so over the top with this, and then I'll hear the producer, I want more energy. So we'll talk about that. And then interviewing skills at the end, when you're on camera, and also if you have the opportunity of interviewing someone else. Here's the basics. We all know about presidential prompters, right, where the glass is at the top. We've seen President Obama and all the other presidents of the White House use this. Then also, you know that this one is the in-studio. You will see this one at CNN. The top ones are for more remote, which is awesome because no matter where you go, you can have a prompter. And then also the newest ones are on the laptops as well. Yes, you can change the font size. It's not one size fits all. So many people are so afraid that they can't read the prompter. And if you're doing something one-on-one, yes, they can change the font size for you, so don't worry. Now, if we're all doing it in a group today, so it'll be kind of in the middle for everyone. Also, if you are squinting, then please let the prompter person know that we need to increase the size. If you increase the size of your font, know that you're going to lessen the words in that screen. And so there's an advantage to having more words on the screen as you're speaking. And of course, the height of the teleprompter can be changed as well. You control the speed. Don't get caught up with, oh my gosh, that prompter is going so fast, so you're going faster. Well, the prompter operator is going faster, and it's going to be a crash and burn. You are the one that controls the speed. Get your pace to a comfortable level. A good operator will follow you, so don't worry about that. Just pace yourself comfortably. You can pause, and you can ad lib. And if you've done your own scripting, you can put in your hash marks for the breathing moments. You can do the dot, dot, dots if you want. Whatever that will catch your eye when you're doing your teleprompter and reading it, that this is your time to comfortably take a breath. Look down if you want, and then continue. You are in control again. If you want to ad lib, fine. As long as you have let the teleprompter operator know that, you know what, there are going to be places that I'm going to ad lib. That puts them on notice. Watch out. Don't keep rolling. The relaxed facial expression. That is something so hard. You know, like, I'm relaxed. I'm smiling. No. A real natural thing is what we're looking for. Warmth, sincerity, and that deer in the headlights look we're trying to get rid of. And believe me, I had that when I first started. We all do. And smile when it's appropriate. Any time that you can have warmth to you, you're going to engage the audience. And that's what you're trying to do. The warmth, the sincerity that comes out, the passion, all of that, and the energy, that makes you a great teleprompter reader. You can gesture. Even though we're in that little television box, don't feel like, you know, you can not move. Go ahead and gesture just like you're talking. It might not all, you know, it won't show. You don't want to do theatrical gesturing, but a little bit so it's natural, so that the audience feels like, wow, you're talking to me. Connecting with your eyes. What we don't want to do is follow the script like, hello, my name is Sachi Koto. I am so glad. No. So you want to be able to grab a couple of the words and then speak as naturally as possible. That's what grabbing words means. And if you all have any questions anytime, let me know. You want to definitely look into the camera. And if you can keep in mind that you're looking into the camera and you're talking to someone you know, talking to friends, it takes a little bit of that stress away from you, and it makes you more relaxed, and you'll speak in a more comfortable manner. You want to connect. You want to breathe from your diaphragm. And I know that's an odd thing to learn in teleprompting, but the more air that you have that catches up into your throat, the less chance you will have with glottal fry. Now, we don't want to have glottal fry, and that's when you don't get enough air in your throat, and so your words crack, or you can't get to the end of the sentence because you don't have enough air. So if you all would sit up, please, and place your hands on your diaphragm. And what we want to do is we want to hold our breath for just a few seconds, and then as we release it, it comes up, out through the back of your throat, through your nose, and through your mouth. And you don't want to, when you want to get your breath, you don't want to go, oh, you want to make it very subtle. That's right. Very subtle. So let's take that subtle breath, and let's hold it. And then gradually release it so no one knows that you're releasing it. And you practice this over and over again. Try practicing this when you're driving, when you're stressed out. I tell you, it will help. It will calm you. It's the same thing that women go through with Lamaze. But it cuts down on stress, and it makes sure that you have enough breath so when you're speaking, you don't have glottal fry, and you can get to the end of your sentences with plenty of breath. To also relax, you want to do some head rolls, and please go ahead and practice this because we'll have you up here in a minute. Do some head rolls, some shoulder shrugs, because what we want to do is relax this part of the body. Because if you're tense, you're going to look and read in a tense way. We want to look natural. We want to look relaxed. Let's talk about scripting. So many times, your script will already be prepared for you. But you have the advantage if you can write your own script. And you want to make it, again, the word is conversational. We don't say, I am going to school. No, you say, I'm going to school, right? So use contractions. You don't want to use the word utilize when you can use the word use. Think about the way you talk. That's the way you want to script it, because when you present this, you want to sound like you're just talking and not reading the lines. You can use capitals and lowercase in your prompters, or CNN style is all caps. So whatever your eyes are better at reading, that's up to you. That's your choice. Make sure that the prompter operator knows that. Write out your numbers, please, because all of a sudden, if you're reading in your script and you got to this thing, whoa, it's an automatic stop for a nanosecond, but you don't want nanoseconds. So you want to have it typed out, 1,325. Now, if it's something rounded off like 1,500, fine. You can do whatever you want. You don't have to say 1,500. Whatever is your speak, whatever is your style, you make sure it's written just for you. So, we're talking about reading conversationally. We're talking about not reading robotically, because we want passion. And then we want expression and warmth. Talking about your voice, we already got some breathing exercises there. We want to enunciate and make sure that you get that last syllable on the ends of the words. So many times people get so nervous, and what you do is you start reading so quickly and you forget that last syllable. And when you do that, you cut out your clarity. So you want to make sure you do that speaking up, that's that projection. Even though you have a microphone here, you have to have that projection, because that projection gives you that authoritativeness in your voice. And vocal variety. Vocal variety is hitting the highs. You know, when you're exciting, it's like, we've got a product we want to tell you about. Or the lows, to cause intrigue and putting pauses in it. Just like when you're going to hit the punchline in a joke, right? So all of that is vocal variety, and it's the opposite of that robotic type of speaking. You want more energy, and like I told you, man, I'm sitting there and I'm reading the scripts and they're, more energy. And I'm thinking, wow, I am so over the top. I go back and I listen to the voice and it's like, wow, they're so right. So even if you feel like, man, I can't do it anymore, you can. It's odd how the tape will pick up differently. So you want that passion. You want to exaggerate it a little bit, not theatrical style, not that much, but you want exaggeration. You want to hit those necessary words. You want to hit those necessary words. And that's the difference. The best thing you can do for yourself is know your material. So when you get your script, look at it, read it, and then mouth it. Reading with your eyes, you won't hit the landmines, but you pick it up and read it out loud. Oh my gosh. You're going to hit the Sally Sells seashells, right? So read it out loud. And now with your wonderful selfie cell phones, read it to that, because the cell phone won't lie. You won't like your voice. You won't like anything about it. But just keep practicing with that, because that is the true test. What if you do something stupid? You know, the CNN live blocks were 4 hours. And people used to ask me, did you ever do anything stupid? I'm like every day? Yes. Have you ever heard of the Porky Pig? You know, when you get stuck in a word, they're like, duh, 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 you know, all the time. But the main thing is recovery. Because, you know, perhaps your audience didn't even notice it, as long as you pick up and keep going. Now, if it's taped and you can do it again, that's different. But in a live situation, just do the Porky Pig, get going. Let's talk about being interviewed. This is probably what will happen with you. You know, if you can talk to the person who's going to interview you beforehand, great. Because once you do that, they become your friends. And so when you're talking to them, they're not some scary person there. So if you have the chance to talk with them, get to know them, and then you can warm up to them. And then when you talk to them later and answer their questions, it'll be a lot more natural. If possible, get them to give you the questions. I know that some reporters, including me, I would not give all of the questions because I wanted spontaneity. But in a setting where it's corporate videos, that's a safe time to know your questions. But then be careful about being in the mode of memorizing, where, oh my gosh, I can't remember the next word. That's not good. So you don't want to memorize your answers. You just want to think broadly about how you're going to answer them. Otherwise, you're going to get stuck on that, oh, what's that next word coming? The skills of interviewing, I know, are based on the five W's, the who, what, when, where, whys, because you know that if someone's going to interview you, they're probably going to be asking you these five W's in some way. So just prepare yourself for that. And find out, is the interview going to be live or taped? Makes a big difference. If it's live, you know, that's that recovery. Do the Porky Pig and get out, right? But if it's taped, you know that they can go back and edit it because they want you to look good. So just find out ahead of time, is it going to be taped or live? Be natural, yes. Be comfortable, try to. And then as be relaxed as possible, and that's getting to know the interview ahead of time. Vice versa, if you have the opportunity of ever being interviewed on of interviewing someone on camera, this is basically the script. You introduce the person, you thank them for being there. You start off with a question that's not too hard, the warm-up question to kind of get friendly there, and then you go into the five W's. You don't ramble. I have a real pet peeve about reporters who ramble so much with their questions, trying to, I think, show off, that the poor interviewer is like, excuse me, would you repeat that question? I didn't understand. So don't show off. Just get to the point. Ask the question. It's not about you. It's about this person that you're interviewing. Segue into the questions like, okay, so now we've talked about blah, blah, blah. Let's move into something else. Transition it so that it's not so choppy and that you're creating a whole story with your interview. Then at the end, summarize. We've been talking with someone and someone, and he's been telling us about this and that. Thank you so much for being with us today. And it just kind of makes a nice close. So your job there is to make your guest comfortable and relaxed. And that's what I'm telling you to be comfortable and relaxed as well. Okay, now what we're going to do is practice on the teleprompter. And we have Miss Teleprompter Extraordinaire, Donna. I'm just going to hand out some of these pages, okay? And just pick a page, please. Sorry. Can I get you to pick out one, please? Oh, sorry?
You want to pass these out?
Yeah, just, just let them pick something. Thank you. Thank you. And I'm sorry, may I reach behind you?
Yep.
Thank you. Did everybody get one? Here's an extra one. Okay, who has number one, please? Oh, would you please come here? And the only lady in the crowd that I noticed. Thank you so much for being here with Donna and with me. And so what we're trying to do is go through some of the tips that I've given. If you'll sit here, please, Mary. Go through some of the tips that I was talking about. And, you know, when I say, be relaxed, it's like, oh, great. You know, how do you command someone to be relaxed? But try to do that. Do some little head rolls now, shoulder shrugs before you come up here. And just kind of warm up and get your mouth kind of warmed up. I had a show at 1 in the morning at CNN, so I had to drive in at some ungodly hours. And I was always going like this now. And so, but that's part of just getting your mouth warmed up, your throat, your face, your shoulders. Mary, go ahead and read over your scripts. Everybody, read over your scripts to familiarize it as much as possible. These were taken from the internet, so they weren't written for anything. But they're the types of scripts that you would be hit with. And I know that Donna can vouch for me that when you're sitting up on the set, these scripts come at you from different writers, different writing styles. It's like, oh my gosh, you can barely get through them. They've got the Sally Sells seashells in it. So.
You ready for Mary to try?
Mary, would you like to try?
Get her microphone really quickly.
Oh, okay. And what you want to do, Mary, is to think that you're reading to someone you know. If you get away from, you know, an audience. And that way, you can put the expression in it. Or, I know that's not written for a child, but if you think, you know how you exaggerate for children when you're reading? It's the same thing. You want to put a little more expression and exaggeration in it. Okay, if we can have your attention, because we have Mary up here now.
How you set your health goals will affect the likelihood of achieving them. New Year's resolutions. We make them every year and just as quickly break them. Hi, this is Mary with best healthy tips and some great ways on how you can throw and set your health goals this coming January. Setting health goals, use the SMART method. You'll be able to better reach your goals. S is for specific. Make your goals specific and detailed. M is for measurable. Measurement means progress. A is for attainable. To be successful, a goal must be doable. R is for relevant. Make sure your goal matters to you. T is timely. Be sure to set a time frame or deadline. New Year's resolutions can be a great opportunity for setting goals. Make sure they are SMART goals, and by this spring, you could be on your way to a whole new you. For more great ideas on ways to be healthy, visit our website at healthygoals.com. Thank you.
Very nice. Mary, I love the quality of your voice.
Thank you.
I had three different voice coaching years across my career. Number one was to get rid of a very, very bad Southern accent.
Oh.
And then also, because I started in broadcasting in 1974, my voice was very high. And that was when women were breaking into the broadcasting industry, and you guys would always yell back, women's voices are too high-pitched, it grates on my ears. So we were trying to learn to lower our voices. So you already have a very nice, rich voice, Mary. And also, the expression, you punched the right words. I know that you only had a few seconds to read here. But it was very, very nice. Donna, did you have any comments? You know, Bina.
She did a video years ago, and you could tell. Yeah,
I've done voice
over.
She's
really good.
Yeah. But the voice quality is real. Yeah. Voice quality is excellent.
Thank you.
So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, who's got number two, please? All right. And what is your first name, please?
Richard.
Richard, please.
Richard's got a nice deep voice.
Yeah, sounds like it. Maybe we're making radio stars and voiceover stars and television stars here today.
I just interviews on podcasts. So.
Please, thank you.
I do interviews on podcasts. Oh, good.
Oh, do you? Oh, good.
You want straight on or Da Vinci or?
You do whatever is comfortable for you.
Okay, ready then? Okay. Managing high blood pressure is within your control. May is National High Blood Pressure Month. Hi, this is Richard Gedney with some advice about high blood pressure, a condition that affects nearly one out of three Americans. It's so important to prevent or control high blood pressure because it can lead to other serious health problems like heart disease, stroke, and kidney failure. The good news is that with diet, medication, and lifestyle, high blood pressure is controllable. I'm Richard Gedney.
Very nice. Mm-hmm. Very nice and smooth. Nice quality. Feedback from the audience? I know you all will be up here. maybe you don't want to say something, but I thought it was very nice. Number three? Oh, please. Yeah. Oh, would you stand up, please? I'm sorry.
Yeah, stand up and take the microphone.
Richard?
Yes, Richard.
I thought that because I was just off, totally taken off guard by her because I know she didn't get a chance to read it. So I thought she did an exceptional job. But I think with Richard, his voice for me was just so calming. Like even the mistake, you're drawn in, so it doesn't bother me as much. Whatever mistake
you made.
Because his voice stayed at an even pitch, and it felt like the voice was reading,
yes,
opposed to him reading. So
very nice. Thank you for that comment. It was very calm, very smooth.
That's what I try to work on. So.
Very good. Who's got number three, please? And your first name?
Mark.
Mark. Thank you.
So now I can consider you a
fan? Yeah. So, Mark, have you ever done this before?
I never have.
Oh, okay.
I never have, no.
Good. This is great that you're here then.
Glad to be here.
And remember you that Donna will follow you.
Okay, thank you. Hi, this is Mark Deal with some advice about high blood pressure. Did you know that as many as 1 in 5 adults don't know they have high blood pressure? That's why it's important to have your blood pressure checked regularly by a health professional or a pharmacy with self-service blood pressure kiosk. Here are some great ways to manage your blood pressure. Lose a little weight, 5 to 10 pounds, or about 10% of your body weight. Avoid drinking too much alcohol, and avoid smoking. For more great ways to stay healthy, visit our website. I'm Mark Deal.
Very nice. For the first time you've ever done that, that's very good. And I was watching your head gesturing. It was very good.
Oh, really?
Yes. Uh-huh.
I'm not used to a video camera. So
you were real comfortable with the pauses, too. You know,
yes, you were.
I screwed up there.
you were good because some people just want to read all the way through.
Yes.
Great.
I do interview folks on an audio show, and I've told them when they make a mistake, just kind of go for a pause because it's easy for the editor. So I don't know how that works in the video.
Same thing. The pausing, though, is like what Donna is saying. It's a skill to know when to pause and just how long before it gets to be a pregnant pause, as we call it, when it makes the audience uncomfortable. But you paused enough, and then you hit the necessary words and the stress words, which were excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Great, for the first time. Wonderful. Thank you, Mark.
Good job.
Okay, number four, right?
Do you want to hand the mic off? Yeah,
your first name, sir.
Larry.
Eric?
Larry.
Oh, Larry. Thank you very much. Larry, have you done this before?
I've done I do training classes and things like that, so I've been up in the front.
Okay, good. And again, we're not playing that catch-up game. Donna will follow Larry.
December is a busy enough month of the year with holiday preparations and events. The last thing you need is a cold, flu, or stomach bug. The answer is staying healthy
It is really small, isn't it?
Yeah,
I
yes.
think
no,
the font's
it's just
larger.
That, it's the brightness, I think, more than that.
Do you need to make the font larger?
No, that's a little better. Okay, that's better. Okay.
Okay.
All right. The answer is staying healthy is right in your hands, literally. This is Larry Brambrett with a simple way to stay healthier at this time of year. Turns out that many, many common illnesses, such as colds, flus, and stomach viruses, find their way into your body through our hands. Cold and flu germs can live up to 48 hours on some surfaces, such as keyboards and doors, and if you touch those surfaces and then touch your eyes or nose, the cold viruses get busy. If soap and water aren't available, a hand sanitizer is the next best thing. It's helpful to have a hand sanitizer available in your car or in your purse, briefcase, or backpack for times when it's not possible or convenient to wash your hands. For more tips on washing and staying healthy, visit our website. This is Larry Brambrett.
Thank you. You know, Larry, I was watching you. Yeah. Your eyes are exactly what I'm talking about. If you can smile with your eyes, you know, and that's what, you probably couldn't see it because he's on the side there, but he had such a warmth, expression on his face, and then his eyes smiled throughout the whole script.
Thank you.
And it was very easy to listen to. It wasn't preachy, you know, like you should wash your hands. It was very nice, so it was I could accept what you were telling me.
Good.
Donna, you have any comments there?
Oh, I just thought he's great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank
Very
you.
Very relaxed.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What's the next number? I've lost count.
Five.
Next, please. Five.
All right.
And your first name?
Dan.
Dan, thank you. Have you done this before?
No.
Good. We like our first-time victim. I mean, we like our first-time participants.
Hello, I'm Dan Turner with the Acme Marketing Company. I want to tell you about a way to make some money while driving your car. Many of the, quote, paid-to-drive companies have since disappeared or have been abandoned. We found that this has been a tactic often explored by startups in the past that fizzled pretty quickly. Companies saw the opportunity as an easy way to sell ads, overlooking the critical importance of matching the right brand and the right design with the right driver. However, some, quote, free car programs or, quote, get paid to drive promotions still exist. These companies want the average driver to go about their normal routines only with a big ad plastered on their car. The car owner is compensated usually a few hundred dollars per month. It's still a way to make some bucks, but do your homework first to make sure you partner with the right company. We would love your feedback. Contact us at Acme Marketing Company. I'm Dan Turner.
Dan, I think you've done this before. And I think you've done it for this type of a commercial.
I used to be in radio, but that was
but
not for TV.
Oh, well, that's fine. I mean, you've got that. There was something there that I said, man, he's done this before.
Oh,
excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you. That was a great ad for your voice, too.
Mm-hmm.
Where did you grow up? What area?
Here. So, okay. I grew up, so I wanted to get into radio. I started radio when I was 13, and when I was 15, I was at WPLO.
Oh,
back
yeah.
Back in 65.
Okay, cool.
So, I started in January 1965, and I left the 1st of May, and I was senior announcer when I left. So that's how the turnover was.
Yeah, that's why I started.
Yeah.
Quixie.
What did you want to get anybody else, or you were showing me the time?
How much more time can
what
we have?
Is it 5 till or is it 5 after? Or
it's 5 till. 6
okay.
Till.
Let's go till noon. Is that
yeah.
okay? And
is
then
that
we've got
you?
Pizza.
Good. Next, please. You all are keeping up with the numbers, and I'm not. Sorry.
6.
And your first name, please.
Rob.
Rob?
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
Rob the introvert.
Oh, good. We love introverts. We love to pick on introverts. Have a seat there in the hot seat.
Number 6.
I doubt that you are an introvert. Because you know why? Because your facial expression. That's not an introverted
That's
face.
Just nervous.
Oh, is that the deer in the headlight look?
Yes, it is.
All right, wonderful.
Anytime.
Okay. Hi, I'm Rob Roy, sales aide with Telesales Agency that helps its clients outsource their inside sales functions. Because of our experience, we are able to increase our clients' sales by utilizing disciplined
prospecting
systems to make effective results, producing cold calls that generate extremely qualified appointments. With an average of 14 years of sales and telemarketing experience, our U.S.-based telesales agents are made up of extremely talented and highly motivated business-to-business appointment setting professionals who have significant skills, training, and enthusiasm. We believe that it's concise and powerful sales pitch that is vital to the success of our clients' appointment settings campaign. We develop a pitch based on your value propositions, success stories, and objectives, qualifications, criteria. Contact us today. I'm Rob Roy.
Thank you for doing that. That's probably the most difficult script in the whole thing.
Yeah, that one was hard.
Poor Rob, you got it. And it's so, that script is so flat. It is so unconversational, and it's got all of those buzzwords in it that for the layperson, it's like, what? You know, so thank you very much for tackling that. I thought you did a great job, and you had a little stumble, but the recovery was excellent, and that's what we're looking for, Rob. And I still don't think you're an introvert. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Who's the next person, please?
I am number 7.
First name, please.
Ward.
And I've met you. Hi, I'm so sorry. I'm a bean brain.
Okay.
I met you at your office. Have you had this experience before, Ward?
Yes, I hate this.
But did you notice? He said, I hate this, but he was smiling.
Hello, I'm Ward Johnson. Worldwide Call Centers is dedicated to being an industry leader in both domestic and international outsourcing. Call Centers globally at Worldwide Call Centers has been serving the outsourcing needs of our clients since December of 1998. Our mission has always been to provide great value by providing our clients with the best possible call center agencies and our call center agencies with the best possible clients. Worldwide has outsourced over 250 million in call center services by assisting hundreds of clients. The Worldwide Call Center Network now consists of over 100 agencies in 25 countries around the world. Our clients range from Fortune 500 companies to small or startup businesses. I'm Ward Johnson.
Very nice. Okay, everybody say Worldwide. I mean, would you have a company? Yes. Well, I'm thinking, would you have a company that where people can't even say it? I mean, that's what happens. The Worldwide. So thank you very much. You did a nice job, Ward, with that.
Thank you.
Thank you. I don't believe that you really hate this stuff.
Oh, yeah, I
hate it. And the next person.
I hate it.
Number 8, is that where we are?
That's me.
There you go.
And no. Your first name, please?
Charles.
Charles.
Yeah. No, never had experience.
Nope, never want this.
And just like him, I would love to love it, but I don't.
Oh, well, we're going to love it after this, because you're among friends.
We ready? Mm-hmm. All right. Hello, I'm Charles Sharper. Bright Ideas helps car dealers optimize their internet sales and marketing by delivering accurate and actionable information while avoiding the distracting details and digital details. Bright Ideas' unique program converts more visitors into leads by creating customized call to action based or their viewing behavior. And just like on your lot, Bright Ideas enables you to observe an online visitor's specific interests before you approach them, converting more leads to sales and action. Bright Ideas dramatically impacts your marketing effectiveness by directing your online spend to the channels by the drive most leads, not just the more traffic. Increase your internet marketing return on investment with the cost-effective, easily implementing product packages. Contact Bright Ideas for demonstrations today. I'm Charles Sharper. Thank you.
Thank you. And that's probably the second hardest script, too. Again, it was really what I call a flat script, so totally non-conversational, had a lot of buzzwords in it, too. Did a good job, Charles. Mm-hmm. I bet you if I worked with you, you'd love this stuff. And I wish that we had more time because it wouldn't be just, you know, getting you up here and getting you off. We could actually work on it. So I apologize that we don't have more time. Who's next? Who's 9, right?
Number 9.
All right.
Calvin,
come on up. Have you done this before, Calvin? I know you're not an introvert.
Not very much.
Not very much? Is that what you're
asking? Not very much. No, okay. Not a lot. Software Plus prides ourselves with offering innovative software and solutions for both corporate businesses and web entrepreneurs. We have time-tested, proven software systems and a highly experienced team to assist in your success. Now you can run your very own profitable network, marketing, referral program, multi-classified site, or other multi-level marketing systems with our unique range of software programs. So if you're thinking of starting a profitable business today, then act now. Try Software Plus on a risk-free trial basis for 30 days, and if you are not totally satisfied, you can return it, no questions asked. My name is Calvin Hill.
Nice.
Nice
job.
Little ad-libbing on there.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Oh.
No questions added.
How about that? Great. Very nice. Thank you, Calvin. Yeah. And then?
Yeah. Doug.
Yeah. Yes.
Time for lunch, right?
The last person holding the little paper.
Now, this is what Doug does.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
I write my own copy. I hate teleprompter. I'm going to learn to like it.
Thank
he
you, Doug.
He does on-air spokes.
Well,
good.
When I write my content, this is a phobia for me.
Well, this, yes.
So I'm brutal.
And these are hard scripts.
Yeah.
I didn't make it easy.
Hi, I'm Doug Lehman. Tasty Peanut has tapped into the new trend in powdered peanut butter. It is now powdered. I'm sorry.
I think we got we got the Sally Sells seashells.
Take it from the top? Or
sure, wherever you want to take it.
Okay. Hi, I'm Doug Lehman, and Tasty Peanut has tapped into the new trend in peanut butter. It's now powdered. We've launched a powdered peanut butter under the Tasty Peanut Health Market Store brand last week. Hate that part. I'm sorry. Reset.
It's okay. Just start from what it's made from.
It's made from powdered peanuts that have been powdered peanut butter.
It does. Talk about the peas.
I'll take it. Take it from there.
Yeah. We're going to vote this one as the worst script, right?
Tasty Peanut Health Market Store brand last week. It's made from powdered peanuts that have been pressed to remove much of the oil and fats. The result... I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Hmm?
You said you hated it.
Yeah, don't worry. It just...
No, but I mean, I've had enough time to look it over.
No problem.
Can we start with it's sold? Mm-hmm. All right.
Wait, let me go.
And I'm not helping you with the speed. I'm fluctuating all over the place.
No, it's fine.
Mm-mm.
Too much editorializing. Let's read the copy, right?
All right. Oh, you're reading through.
Yeah. I'm going to from the top. Tasty... Peanut Health Market store brand last week. It's made from powdered peanuts that have been pressed to remove much of the oil and fats. The result of peanut butter tastes with less fats and calories. It's sold in, the powder can be mixed with water to create a desired peanut butter consistency you want. Our powdered peanut butter is making headlines for having much of the protein, but less of the traditional fat and calories of traditional peanut butter. Buy some today and be healthier for it. I'm Doug Lehman, and I'm tired of talking about powdered peanut butter.
And see, wasn't that a great ad lib? I'm Doug Lehman, and I'm not going to do the script again.
Everything you said about, everything you said prior to doing this, I went into the robotic phase. I went into all that. I couldn't read the copy. So
see, I paid him to do this for us. You know, see, Doug. Hey, any time you have all the pa-pa-pas or we had the worldwide whatever,
yeah.
I'm worried with world. I mean, come on. How many times do you have all those W's?
And I have seen Doug do lots of on-camera stuff, and it's very, very good. I think you're overthinking it. Because you do this, you're the only one that really does this. And I think you overthink it and got nervous.
A whiteboard, and I look at three keywords and I go from it.
What do you want to say?
Wait, stand up.
Would you please?
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Doug.
So I had to give a presentation 7-8 years ago to a pretty large... sales organization, and the script was written for me, unfortunately, and I stumbled on successful. And sex came out. But the funny thing was, everybody laughed. And then I tried to say it again, and I said sex. So I just stumbled all over it, but it was funny.
You know, Ward, I think, so if we had a lot of broadcasters in here, I bet Don and I could go through the same thing. I had a co-anchor, and he said the Grand Prix when he was doing sports. And I remember, yeah, I'm sitting, I'm off camera because he's doing sports and I'm off, and I went, and he could have probably gone on, but this big whoop came out from the other side. So, I don't know, these Freudian slips come out, and oh, I've done much worse than the Porky Pig. I've just kind of put them way back here in the mind. So. But if we had time, I'm sure it would all come gushing out. And I had one wonderful anchor tell me early on in my career, when I just really flubbed so badly, I just thought about giving up broadcasting completely. And he said, Sachi, every mistake has already been made on camera. Don't think, you are so unique. Every mistake has been made. Just pick yourself up, keep going on. And that's Chuck Moore. He was a main anchorman here in Georgia for so many years. Such a model person, and a wonderful role model for me.
I've never seen you make a mistake on CNN, though.
Oh, you must have been all the taped ones. You're sweet. Thank you. Thank you so much for being such good sports today. You know, it's so hard, and if we had more time, I could work with you and probably work out a lot of these lack of confidence issues that you have. Believe me, I'm sure Donna will tell you, I know I will, starting off with teleprompters, it was, and then we just have to go from there. But you all did a great job, and remember, half of it, or maybe even 75% of it, it was the scripts, and I know that. So I was just kind of testing the water with you. But thank you so much, and I hope you have a great day with Donna.
Thank you.